Welcome to this video. In this video, we are going to see the data validation. I am selecting data validation. I am giving different color and font. So this is the data set. In this data set, I am asking the students to enter the data or employees data. Employee data, we are giving one pre-printed form to the employees, ask them to fill the data, right? So ask them to fill the data in the sense they should know what data should be filled in the column. Otherwise, we should give the clear information saying that if it is a gender column, you have to use only male, female, other. If it is the application sold, where is that application sold? Okay, if it is a first name in the sense you have to use, you should not go beyond the 10 characters because the cell contains only 10. Even if you are trying, it won't permit. Generally, applications will be comes with the some instruction, right? So here, the same way, I am going to create one new application, application number. The next one is which course they are choosing, postgraduate programs. So these postgraduate programs, these are the courses in the postgraduate diploma in management courses. So the PGP in the sense, the student has to select any one of the course, right? So to make the process simple, we can make this list to display here. They can choose one from the list. Okay, so that is what we are going to do now. And this one is the application sold, application number. So what application is you are already sold, that application number only you should able to give here. You cannot give 1, 2, 3 because we started the application number 1000 till 5000 only sold out. Application number also simply bearing the same thing, 1000 to 5000. So that is the only restricted number should be entered here. But the participant, otherwise the applicant, may not understand what it means. By the time we have to give the proper information to the participant. How can we give? With the help of the data validation. We will see that. And the name, they can enter the name, but the name should not be go beyond 10 characters. That restriction also should be known to the student. How we are going to convey this information, that only we are going to see now as a part of data validation. I am just underlining this for easy purpose. Okay. Application number. So what is application number? I am trying 101. Will it accept? Yes, it is accepting. But already what we sold 1000 to 5000 only. So what should be the valid value here? 1000 to 5000 including those numbers. Otherwise, we should not accept. So here, just keep the mouse pointer here. Let us assume 101 is already there. Okay. Keep the mouse pointer here and go to data. The data is the menu bar. Click the data. Here, the data tools. One, you can find data validation. Select that. In these three options, select the first one, data validation. Now we are getting some dialog box. There we can see three tabs. One is settings, input message. Another one is error alert. The first one window showing allow. We are going to allow some data. What data? That is from a list. What is the list? That list I'll be giving. Otherwise, we are going to allow only whole numbers. So this is appropriate, right? We can permit only list. Otherwise, we can ask them to type only date in case of data about joining date, like, or time or some other text. Anything we can give the restrictions. Now I want to give the restriction with the whole numbers. The whole numbers, what are the whole numbers between or equal to or not greater than? So these are the options we can use. I want to say the minimum number is 1000 and the maximum number is 5000. So this is what the application numbers we sold, right? So that is why I'm using here. Say okay. Now see this implementation, that application, this instructions created already given to this cell. Already 101 is already there. So that is what simply holding that existed data. But if you are typing another data 102, it won't accept. Simply it will throw some error. So what is the error? A default error given by the Excel system. The value entered is not a valid. Okay, it is a wrong value. But what is the right value? The system is not telling. I am also not able to understand. So that also should be given at the time of entry, otherwise along with the error message. Now see, you type, I know these values, that is why I can easily type 1000. Will it accept? Yes, it is accepting. So they cannot try the trial and error method, no, at the time of application filling. we should give the proper information. So what we can do, just to go once again back to the data and data validation, select the first one. The existed one is 1000 to 5000. Now you come to the input message. Okay. So here, what you want to display, show the input message when cell is selected. If the student coming to select the cell to enter the data, by the time it has to display what information? Enter 1000 to 5000 only. Okay, enter 1000 to 5000 only. Okay, so here enter your application number. Okay, right, you see, no, you say okay. Now if you are coming to this cell and it will be showing that enter your application number, enter 1000 to 5000 only. Okay, so by seeing this, the applicant easily understands what is the application number. Okay, now see 2000, it is accepting. What of this cell 3000 or 300? As accepting, yes, accepting, because the criteria has been implemented only to this cell. Where to extend the criteria data validation formula to all remaining cells also till where you want to go. Okay, the 10 columns or 5 columns or complete Excel sheet, like, okay. So before entering this value, you can make this value, you can copy to another value, but the 1000 also copied. So what we can do at the time of entry, you should make sure that the cell is empty so that only the criteria will be copied, rather the existing data. Okay, so you see, now I am deleting this value, it is not accepting. Okay, no issues. Once again, I am unchecking. So keep the mouse pointer there, go to data, data validation, select the first one, input message, the settings also you have to fix first. Okay, application number. Valid from 1000 to 5000. That's it. You say okay. You say okay. Now it is still the backend. Now we copy this some more columns, so that even if you are going to this place, we can see the prompting message, data validation number. Now here you can enter 3434. It is accepting. Okay, if you are selecting this cell, then only we can see this message. See, coming to next column, the name. So what message we can give? Go to data validation, you select that, the settings. So what you want to text, the text should be equal to, otherwise less than 10 characters. Only 10 characters will be accepted. Or for easy purpose, I am giving only 5 characters or 6 characters. Okay, I say okay. In case input message, you can give some other information. In case of alert, we can use alert. What kind of alert you want to stop? If any error happen or any warnings, you want to give strict warning to the participant, or just you want to give the information. Okay, so these are the 3 levels of warnings, can be error alerts can be given. So you select the stop one, give the title and put the relevant information. And warning, you give the title, relevant information. So the same way, you give the title and give the relevant information. That is what we are going to give based on the selection, the level of the error message. So now we are telling that only 6 characters. I don't want to give any information here. Okay, just saying okay. How many characters? 5 characters. That also should be given. No. So validation, and go to the information. Only 5 characters allowed. Now see, the message will be perfect. At the same time, the previous information previously entered also should be updated. No, apply these changes to all other cells with the same settings. You select this so that they will be applied to see this criteria going to apply all the cells. Save, okay. That's it, there in the matter. Okay. Now gender. Here we are going to use some list. So how we can do this? Select the cell, go to data validation and select the data validation. Here what value you are going to give? This is from a list. You are going to give some list. What is the list? The male and female and other, right? So these are the three is a list. So the list source is this one. You select this. You don't select the titles. Okay. And come back, click on the right point. Now see, okay. Now you can see the list box icon here. You can see this. Before selecting, I am copying the same criteria to other cells. After selecting the male or female, those data also will be going to copy it. So to avoid this, I am copying the empty cells. Now see, you go to anywhere in the selected implemented cells, you can see this. You select and choose the data. You see how easy it is, right? So this is the list information, the PGP. The PGP also same thing. Keep the mouse pointer here, or you see only you select all the cells in the beginning itself. Go to the data validation, select the first option. What you are going to implement? I am going to implement the list. What is the list source? You just click the red point and come to this one. You leave these courses and select the remaining, or select from the title, that also will be displayed. Okay, right? You see, I am selecting one more empty column also. And any error message required? No need, simply say okay. Now see, you can see the courses. You can choose the courses also as a course, but this is not the correct. No, the course name supposed to be selected, so this should not be part of the list. So that is why go back to data validation and select the list, and instead of the courses you choose these remaining and apply. Okay, now see, you can select. Now the course is not available. You can select any course, any number of time also you can change. This is the way we can implement in cell display list. Okay, so in case of date of birth, equal to date of birth. So what should be permitted? The permitted is only selecting copy and rightly and paste special and formats I want to copy. See, format copy. Okay, now the date of birth, you select the cells and go to the data validation and settings, any value. In this any value, you have to select the date format. So what is the date between or equal to 1998? So the date supposed to be greater than this value. See, okay. Save, okay. Data is invalid. Okay, you don't think, use hyphen. Now try. It is accepting. So beyond the date only it will be accepting. 33 given, no, I am giving 2 2 1995. See, error, because the date is not coming in the range. If you are giving 3 or 5 5 1996 given, I am giving 98. Let me accept. Yeah, it is accepting. So like that, we can use the data validation for this kind of different purposes. Okay, I hope this video is very helpful for you. Thank you for watching.